Take a look. Board of directors employs the man for 7.5 seconds. screwdriver.
Mills are paying up the packing plant? 93 out. Not even paying either.
Screwdriver!
Oh, Mr. Sorokin.
Yes, Mabel.
Mr. Hassler's gone to shipping room. He wants you right away.
I got to finish this.
He can be quite difficult sometimes. You're the third superintendent we've had this year.
And I'm the last superintendent you'll have this year, Mabel, because I want this job.
Oh, you don't say.
Now you're talking, boy.
We're going to need a switch.
I'll tell him you're awfully busy.
Thanks.
And let me tell you something else. They're paying 84 up at the casket.
My gosh! You'd be a sensation at the casket company. Maybe if you could get a job as a tester and lie around in coffins all day long. Now hurry up!
I'm hurrying.
Well, hurry faster!
Hey, you can't do that to me!
The hell I can't. I just did.
Well, I'll fix you. I'm getting the grievance committee.
Good. Go get them. It'll give you something to do.
I don't take that crap off nobody!
Get away from me, boy! You bother me.
Well, I'll sue you. On my weak arm, too!
That grievance committee came started by the rhubarb.
This whole town's a rhubarb.
You'll get used to it.
I hope so. We're gonna need a bigger switch and we'll need a fuse.
I'll go down to the store.
Well, give him a hand! Move!
A new town is a blue town. Who do you know and show you what you can do, town? There's no red carpet at your feet. If you're not tough, they'll try to beat you down in a new blue town. It's not like the old town. It doesn't take long to find that you're in a cold town. But you know you can lick it. Didn't buy your round trip ticket to this cold, cold new blue town. Well, nobody asked me to come here, and nobody asked me to stay. Tried to make me say goodbye, town. But I won't leave until I make it my town. They'll see this one poor stupid pick of a new town ain't gonna let me.
Mr. Hess is looking for you. Did you get lost?
I had to fix the number 9 machine.
I expected you in the shipping. When did you get so familiar with him? Say, what is happening?
Friendly, hot. You're always flirting. Dancing on the green. Deep boxes.
Next time when I send for you, I'll expect you. That's the way we run things around here.
Since that first day when I said hi, town, they damn well tried to make me say goodbye, town. But I won't leave until I make it my town. They'll see this one horse two-bit hick of a new town ain't gonna lick me.
Mr. Sorokin, I told you to be careful. When I heard about you beating up that boy today,
I didn't beat him up.
He's dangling his arm like it hurt terrible.
Well, let him take it up with the grievance committee.
He's doing that, don't worry. Here comes Babe Williams now.
Good. I'll be delighted to talk to him.
All right, mister. Here's the grievance committee.
This is the grievance committee?
That's right, Mr. Sorokin. This is the committee. Charlie, this committee is different. I'm sorry. All right, look, I shoved the kid. What's the next move?
Well, he says that you hit him.
No, I just... Look, Miss Wilson, I've got a lot of things on my plate right now.
My name is Miss Williams.
What's the difference?
I'm sorry, Miss Williams.
It doesn't matter.
Well, he ought to know the committee's right name.
Take it easy. Mr. Sorokin, I have quite a few problems of my own right now. This helper here says you socked him.
Oh, he does.
Yes, I do.
Let's say I shoved him. It sounds more refined.
Oh, Mr. Sorokin, Mr. Hassel wants to see you in his office right away.
Tell him okay.
Oh, but this is a crisis. The tops are 15 minutes behind the bottoms.
Look, let's be practical. This is a lot of damn nonsense.
Well, we don't happen to think so, Mr. Sorokin. You're not supposed to strike an employee. We have rules about that.
For both sides, I hope. Let me spread it on the table. This young man needs vocational guidance.
Oh, think so.
Well, he wants to be a bank president. I don't think he's happy being a factory helper.
I don't see what all this has to do with it.
Oh, forget it. Well, it seems you haven't made a very good impression on our new superintendent.
Well, he ain't got no right to shove me around, especially on my weak arm.
Look, I gotta get this factory up and going. Can we do this another time?
Absolutely, Mr. Sorokin. That's in the rule book, too.
You can't go shoving me around. You're broke once already.
Thanks for your cooperation, Miss Williams.
It's all in the rule book.
You know, I gotta read this rule book sometime.
Yes, you certainly should.
All I have to say is, you are the cutest grievance committee I have ever had to deal with.
Hurry up, guys, hurry up! I've got my stopwatch on you. Hurry up, hurry up!
When you're racing with the clock, when you're racing with the clock, and the second hand doesn't understand, the track may break, and your fingers ache, your constitution isn't made of rock. It's a losing race when you're racing with the racing, with the racing, with the clock.
You're whispering in his ear. All you gotta do is be polite with him, and they've got you spending the night with him. If there's a guy you merely have a beer with, they've got you setting the wedding date.
Seems they've just gotta have some dirt
to bend your ear with. So before they start, I herewith state I'm not at all in love, not at all in love, not I, not a bit, not a mite, though I'll admit he's quite the hunk of guy, but he's not my cup of tea, not my cup of tea, not he, not an ounce, not a pinch, he's just an inch too sure of himself for me. But I'm not at all in love, not at all in love, not I, not a straw, not a hair. I don't care if he's as strong as a lion, nor if he has the rest of you sighing. You may be sold, but this girl.
Figures for Mr. Hassler?
They're in the file.
Where's your boss?
On the first floor. A couple of the girls had a fight. Superintendent's office. Yes, Dolores Paradiso, that's her name. She's supposed to be very elegant. She can sew a button on a fly like she was pouring tea for the Queen of England. Come in. Oh, yeah, she can pull hair all right. A couple of the girls spoiled some goods. When Mr. Hassler finds out, there'll be blood all over the place.
Want to buy a ticket for the picnic?
Might as well get it over with.
$1 and all the beer you can guzzle.
No beer for me, thanks. Gives me heartburn, something awful.
Me too.
You.
Are you going to do your nice one at this game, Mr. Hines?
Oh, I suppose so. There always seems to be a demand for it.
Was you honest on the real stage?
That's where I first met him, Poopsie. He was throwing knives at some woman in the Majestic Theater.
Mr. Hassler in his office?
No.
Oh. Here, one hard-earned dollar. And I hope the ham ain't half as salty as it was last union picnic. I was dried up for a week after.
What are you doing, leaving him a note?
All right.
I saw you leave that note. I'm not blind. That's why you wore that low-cut dress to work today.
Sometimes you make me scream, Vernon. You just make me scream!
Martha, prove it. I dare you to show me what's in that note.
There, read it, then go cut your throat.
Payroll, $7,502.01.
That means I love you in the Morse code.
Ain't you ashamed of yourself, Hinesy?
Now that we got that all straightened out, you think you can trust me as far as the ladies' room?
I learned my lesson. I'll never be jealous again.
Maybe I'll give you cause someday.
I learned my lesson, Mabel. I'll never be jealous again.
Hinesy. Hinesy.
Never.
You stick to it now.
Absolutely.
That's easier said than done.
I can do it.
I knew it. But let's take an example just for fun. Picture this. You're sitting and waiting for her to come back from a
day. There I am. I'm sitting and waiting for her to come back from a day.
Here she comes. Her blouse is unbuttoned. Her stockings are not very straight.
Here she comes. Her blouse is unbuttoned. Her stockings are not very straight.
Later on, she gets a bouquet with a card in it saying to baby, you were great. Well, Hinesy, what would you do then?
I would trust her. I would trust her. By George, I swear I would trust her. No, I'll never be jealous again.
Nice work, Hinesy. Let's take another example. Picture this. You've nothing to do, so you drop in to chat for a while.
There I am. I've nothing to do, so I drop in and chat for a
while. Something's up. The window is open and Gladys is forcing a
smile. The window is open and Gladys is forcing a smile.
Can you see a shirt and a tie and a pair of pants in a nice, neat little pile? Well, Hinesy?
I would trust her. I would trust her. By George, I swear I would trust her. No, I'll never be jealous. I'll never, 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 never be jealous again.
That's the stuff, Hinesy. You're practically cured.
There will be no more nightmares to sleep through. No more keyholes to peep through.
No more bushes to creep through.
That's my plan.
Well, now that you're a new man, picture this. You go to your sweetie's apartment, you borrow the keys.
There I am. I go to my sweetie's apartment, I borrow the keys.
There she is. She's given a sailor a very affectionate
there
squeeze.
There she is. She's given a sailor a very affectionate squeeze.
Then to boot, she tells you she was in the arms of her cousin who's back from overseas.
Her cousin back from overseas, you I would trust her. I would trust her. By George, I swear I would trust her. No, I'll never be jealous. I'll never, 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 never be jealous again.
right is the union to run their Coca-Cola machine with my electricity? It is just as Fool News Jr. said last night. Say, Sorokin, do you listen to Fool News Jr.?
I'm rather flexible on the matter.
Boy, has he got venom. Keen mind, one of the greatest speakers in the country today. Should listen to him every single night. Should be in every executive contract. What's he looking at? This book shouldn't be here. Thomas!
Yes, Mr. Hassler?
Where have you been?
I've just been to the ladies. Isn't that all right?
Not this book.
Oh, Mr. Hassler, you scared the life out of me. It's okay, I got the key right here.
I don't want it left lying around. Is that clear?
Yes, Mr. Hassler.
If I can't trust Gladys, who can I trust?
I wouldn't know.
What was my book doing here anyhow?
Sid, who's that Fulton Lewis Jr. he's always talking about?
He plays third base for the White Sox.
Oh.
Old man's got a bad case of bookitis, hasn't he?
Oh, yes.
I wonder if he's got any skeletons locked up in there. Say, Mabel, what kind of girl is this Babe Williams?
Babe? She's peppy, full of spunk.
Is she married?
No, not quite.
What do you mean, not quite?
Well, she was close once. She was engaged to the Johnson boy, and then one time at a football game, she pushed him off the end of the bleachers and gave him a concussion. That broke the engagement.
Outdoor girl.
Gladys is crying. She is hysterical. I don't know.
Well, she brought the ledger up here to enter the cost totals, Mr. Hassler.
Well, why the hell could you say so?
Give me Letty's pants. Is that you, Perez? Sorokin speaking. Say, whatever happened to the complaint of the helper I'm supposed to have socked? I'd like to get that settled. Could you send the grievance committee up here? No, right away. Thanks.
I heard you had an eye for her.
Hear things easy around here, don't you? Next thing you know, they'll be talking about us.
Don't think it hasn't been mentioned.
Memo, cutting foreman. Committee rejects. Array on crepe numbers. Oh, come in.
Hello.
Have a seat.
Thank you.
Look into it and report back.
Yes, Mr. Hassler, I'll be there right away. Gladys is still crying. He needs me to take a couple of letters.
I wanted to talk to you about that assault and battery case.
Well, we thought we would just forget about that, Mr. Sorokin.
Yes.
Yeah, we all knew that injured arm was a bunch of nonsense. Well, to tell you the truth, we've had trouble with him before.
I believe it. If you would have known the trouble I had to go through just to get him to kick across the screwdriver to me, I'd have been justified if I had socked him.
Well, we won't get into that. Anyhow, we have it down in our books as a slight nudge.
Personally, I think a little physical contact is good for people once in a while.
Oh, do you, Captain Bly?
Not exactly. Won't you sit down for a minute with Miss Williams? How about a date?
A what?
How about we go out to dinner sometime?
Well, gee, I don't know.
We could check up on the local hot spots.
Thanks, but I don't think so.
What is this strange power I have over women?
Well, it really wouldn't work. Oh, no, not at all.
Really struck out that time, didn't I?
Well, it's nothing personal. It's just that you're the superintendent and in the grievance committee.
Memo, timekeeper, make sure the girls Memo, Sid Sorokin.
Hey there, you with the stars in your eyes. Love never made a fool of you. You used to be too wise. Hey there, you on that high-flying cloud. Though she won't throw a crumb to you, you think someday she'll come to you. Better forget her, her with her nose in the air. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice I hand you like a brother? Or are you not seeing things too clear? Are you just too far gone to hear? Is it all going in one ear and out the other? Hey there,
I hear
with the stars in your eyes.
Me?
Love never made a fool of you.
Not until now.
You used to be too wise.
Yes, I was.
In Massillon, in Chillicothe, Van Wert, Napoleon. Finest season I ever had.
Well, I'm gonna have to make an announcement about the mix-up. It seems there ain't gonna be enough baked beans to go around.
Okay.
But there's plenty of potato salad, so them that don't like potato salad could go heavy on the baked beans, and vice versa. Okay.
Say, where's Hansie, Gladys?
He couldn't keep up with me.
Boy, they gotta be good to keep up with you. And this is the day I say, let yourself go, huh?
You wanna go somewhere?
Oh, you know what I mean. Say, that's a mighty nifty outfit you got on. I'd go for that.
You like it? I brought pants along just in case. Heinzie says this is too revealing.
It ain't too nothing. You tell Heinzie to go roll a hoop down Main Street. You got class, honey. You are beautiful.
Oh, I know I'm beautiful. Probably the most beautiful girl north of Keokuk, Iowa. But you got a wife, Prez.
Oh, forget that. Her and these total strangers. Listen, baby.
I wouldn't never tell this to nobody else but you. To nobody else but you, I wouldn't never tell this. What I mean to say is you're different from the rest. Maybe you're the best. And I wouldn't never tell this to nobody else but you.
I'll go on.
Kind of doll what drives a fella bats, isn't her?
Her is.
Her has. A kind of shape what really is the cat's, hasn't her?
Her has.
My wife, she ain't understanding, she ain't like her is. This here ain't no line I'm handing, or I should drop dead right where I'm standing. Her is a snappy dresser, what is dressed to kill, isn't her?
Her is.
Her is the only doll from which I get a thrill, isn't her?
Her is.
Her is running away, but her sure can bet him is gonna get her yet. I'm gonna get her yet. Her is a kind of doll what drives a fella bats, isn't her?
Her is.
Her has
time to shake what really is the cat's. Hasn't her?
Her has.
Her is running away, but her sure can bet. Him is gonna get her yet. I'm gonna get her yet. On account of we all know him, and it's always good to have him with our midst. But it gives me great pleasure to introduce y'all to our boss, Mr. Myron Hassler. Okay, Mr. Hassler.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm proud to be here. We are all members of a great industry. And to that industry, we owe our lives and our daily bread. In return, we must recognize the stern obligations placed upon us in these terrible times of economic upheaval and governmental chaos. I can never remember a time when competition was so ruthless. Dealers so cantankerous, costs outrageous, and profit margins sunk so low. My good friends, pajamas are a crossroads! Whether your company can go on to greater things lies in you. Whether your company can weather the storm of rising costs is a grave question. Thank you.
Thanks, Mr. Hassler. That certainly was nice, and it's always good to have you with us. Now, directly after the festive board meeting, there will be a knife-throwing exhibition by Professor Vernon Hines. Now, the baseball game will start at 1:30 sharp between the finishing room and the ladies' pants. Now, this is a grudge contest, and it ought to be good. Now, who wants to be my partner in a three-legged race? That's all.
Don't miss a knife throw. Better get going.
Why, hello, gorgeous. How about another beer?
All right.
This way. No, it's this way.
What are they doing? Drunk out of the What? Yeah. Well, if it isn't Miss Grievance Committee.
Oh, hello.
I've got a grievance. There's this fella, Sid Sorokin, knocking himself down trying to be a dandy fella, but he can't seem to make a score.
Well, you tell him Miss Williams is a very cold, hard-boiled doll, and well, he wouldn't like her at all if he got to know her.
I'll tell him, but he's an awful problem, stubborn as hell.
No, I don't. Some people no sense at all, darn fool.
What happened to you?
Lorenzo, place my knives.
Hurry, 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 for a riot of thrills. Introducing Professor Vernon Hines.
Yeah!
Master of the Flying Blades. Now, in his sensational demonstration of iron nerve, and skill exactly as performed in front of the crowned heads of Missouri and Kansas.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Are you ready, Professor?
Say, is the trained nurse in attendance?
The trained nurse is here.
The excitement may prove far too great a strain on our fair spectators. Ladies and gents and ladies, your kind attention. Here we go! One, two, three! Oh, get back! Get back, we'll do it again. Do it again.
Yes.
Okay. I'm Zwei! Now, if some daring young lady in the audience will consent to stand against the board, I will show you this act as it should be played.
Hey, don't get foolish!
I'll do it!
You knock the apple off my head, Hindy!
Just relax, it's not like I'm throwing them at you! One! Two! Three!
Give me that! What are you thinking?
Where's my...
Don't be a damn fool!
Making you nervous? How the hell do you think I feel?
Don't you shoot me!
Go on, shoot, Professor!
Oh, just calm down! I won't hurt you! Okay! One! Two! Three!
Come on! Get down from there! Come on! Get these tables out of here! Damn it, no!
It's an insult! My skill is
gone!
I tell you, I'm not jealous.
I didn't say you were jealous. I said you were drunk.
Oh, you can't have everything.
Say, May, where are you headed to?
Oh, no place special.
But my, you're an impetuous girl.
I get along all right.
You know that defiant policy is going to get you in a lot of trouble someday, Catherine Williams.
Well, it seems to be working out just fine so far.
Listen, I've got a new policy in mind for both you and me.
Oh?
Let's quit fighting.
What fight?
Come here, Catherine.
Where are we going?
Babe and Sid are going for a walk together. The new policy.
Gee, baby, you're terrific.
You're not so bad yourself.
This is my once-a-year day. Felt the morning sun and knew that this was my once-a-year day. Even got a kiss from you, I feel like hopping up and down like a kangaroo. Jumping fences, climbing trees, what pleases me is what I'll do, cause this is a once-a-year day.
Look at Charlie up a tree, kissing Katie's ear.
Sounds gruesome to me.
Well, that ain't the worst of it. Come on, Charlie, if I can make it, you can. Well, anyway, he was Elsie Bartlett's second cousin, fell into the concrete mixer when they were building the new bridge.
My God!
They never did find the body, so they poured the concrete and held the funeral on top of the second pier on the Illinois side.
What I like about people, bring people together.
They sure do.
I never thought you was aware I was alive until today.
How could I miss you? You're the kind of girl that stands out in the crowd. You've got what it takes. Something else? That's a mighty elegant outfit you got on.
Oh, it's just casual. Look, Prez, what would your wife say?
Oh, her and me, we hardly talk to each other anymore.
You don't?
Certainly not.
You know, something I like about you.
Oh!
You got such a swell brain.
So have you.
You're a snappy dresser, too.
Oh, I get around.
I go for that.
I go for you. Ha, ha, ha. Ha, ha, ha. Her is a kind of doll that drives a fella bats, isn't her?
Her is.
Her has. A kind of shit what really is the cats, hasn't her?
Her has.
I've seen what girls east to the west have, none have what her has. Yes, I have seen what the best have, but you have twice as much as the rest have. Her is a snappy dresser, what is dressed to kill, isn't her?
Her is.
Her is. The only doll from which I get a thrill, isn't her?
Her is.
Her is running away, but her sure can bet him is. Gonna get her yet. I'm gonna get her yet.
Well, you know, when he first came here last week after the picnic, she says to me, don't be no pest, don't talk too damn much. I think it'd be worse if I didn't talk at all, eh, Sin?
You're right.
I would say, railroad man could be never too much no damn pest, never home enough.
You go out on the run tonight, don't you?
Yep, off to Milwaukee, doggone it. Say, it's something you don't see every day.
I agree. What is it?
Petrified bat.
Now, Pop, Sid is not interested in petrified bats.
Ah, I say he was.
Well, I know you.
The tyranny of women.
Well, that's too bad.
Well, I better go get my things. Old number 15 waits for no man.
Pop built your ears off?
He's a nice guy, babe. Mm-hmm. I like him. But I like you.
No, no, no. Wait till Pop goes out. Are you hungry?
Not exactly hungry. Not in the way you mean, at least.
Oh, you. Here, have a beer.
Thanks.
They say you like sand.
Pop!
What it say he does. This should be something interesting to anybody. Two sets of mint Colombians and a plate block issue since 1919.
Well, thanks.
Anytime, Sid. Goodbye, honey.
Bye, Pop.
Say, now we can settle down to a nice long evening with the stamp collection. Well, say, he does have a full set of Mint Colombians.
Well, sure he does. And that's why I work at Sleep Tight.
He's a nice guy, babe.
You're a good boy, Sid. He likes you, too.
I feel good, babe. I feel like home.
I wonder if we've got any onions.
Onions?
Yeah, I'm gonna make a Western. Do you want one?
That's my baby, boys. She wants a Western. No, honey, I do not want a Western. Food is not uppermost of my thoughts at the moment.
Well, I guess you'll want some coffee, too, then.
No, it'll keep me up. Now cut it out.
What's the matter, lover?
I don't want to talk small talk. Now that I'm alone with you, I don't wanna talk small talk.
address the one that I have is such a mess.
Small talk.
Who will we vote for next election? How do you like the stamp collection?
Small talk. I read in a book the other day that halibut spawn in early May, and horses whinny and donkeys bray, and furthermore, the pygmy tribes in Africa may have a war.
Oh,
yes. I don't wanna talk.
What do you think they charge for him now?
Now that I'm alone with you.
That's so a bum game worth a damn now.
I don't wanna talk.
The weather witches are getting wilder.
We've got bigger things to do.
And that the teenage kids are wilder.
Let's not talk about the weather.
One of these days I'll paint the kitchen.
The fashions for the
ball.
Why don't you stop all this small talk?
Like I was saying,
I've got something better for your Leo to do.
I think I'll make that western now.
Oh, babe, have a heart.
Oh, and every darn apron in the wash.
That's your biggest concern in life, isn't it?
Well, I do not want to get grease spots on this dress. I paid $20 for it.
Well, take it off. You're among friends.
Hey, look out. I'm cooking.
You sure are.
Well, I guess I might as well be practical. Would you hang this up for me, please?
Gee, I sure do love a girl walking around in her slip. You know, if I was an Oriental potentate and harem, I'd want those girls to walk around in slips rather than those damn pants. Now, how the hell do you hang this thing up?
Keep trying, lover.
Sports coat, meet Miss Williams' dress. You kids get acquainted now. Babe, I love you. Darling?
Sid, there's something I gotta talk about.
What?
Well, you're wonderful, you know, and I love you, but we're in for a lot of trouble.
Oh, no, baby. Why should we be?
Well, there's something going to come between us.
Who?
Not any who. 7.5 cents.
Oh, that.
Well, that contract, lover, that's important. Maybe we ought to face that.
Don't talk nonsense.
Sid, you mustn't treat me like a baby.
I'm not, darling.
You've got to listen. I don't know why the union's so important to me, but it is. I guess you got to be part of a team or something. Well, that's why, no matter what's with us, I'm going to be fighting for my side and fighting hard.
All right. Babe, how do you feel about me?
I love you terribly.
Well, if we both feel that way about each other, isn't that enough?
You don't know me.
Babe, I love you.
All right. I guess I can take it if you can.
I don't wanna talk small talk. I've got something better for your lips to do, and that takes no talk at
Mr. Hester called me today.
Called you what?
Not really. I spoke to him personally.
No,
he says he wants to see us tomorrow in his office at noon.
Does that mean we've won? We've won? We've won! We've won! We've won!
I'm sorry.
Man, calm down. Mr. Hester just wants to talk to us.
Sure is busy these days.
Well, I don't think a girl should get too emotional over the management.
Babe can take care of herself.
The trouble is when you start falling for a guy. You don't know how far you're gonna fall.
Oh, hello, babe. We're talking about you.
Well, why not?
Are you coming?
No, I can't. I've got a date.
Have fun.
I will. Here I am.
Hi.
Hi.
Did I keep you waiting?
Well, no, that makes it much nicer when you get here.
Well, I got one more thing to do. Do you mind another 5 minutes?
Sid, I don't mind anything. I love you.
I love you more.
Babe, are you happy?
Sid, I don't even touch the ground.
It's good, isn't it?
So good. I can hardly believe it. Tell me.
Again?
Tell me.
I love you.
Tell me.
I love you more than all the heroes and all the history books in all the world.
Tell me.
What a woman.
I'll tell you.
There once was a man who loved a woman. She was the one he slew the dragon for. They say that nobody ever loved as much as he. But me, I love you more.
Tell me!
And there once was a man who loved a woman. She was one he gave his kingdom for. They say that nobody ever loved as much as he. But me, I love you more. My love is a giant, fierce and defiant, but how can I prove this to you? Ain't got no kingdom, no dragon to back up my bragging. I only know what I can do. I only know there once was a man who loved a woman. She was one he ate the apple for. They say that nobody ever loved as much as he. But me, I love you more.
Once was a woman who loved a man. He was one that she took poison for. They say that nobody ever loved as much as she. But me, I love you more. And there once was a woman who loved a man. She was one he swam the channel. Tell you how it feels. I only know that once was a woman who loved a man. Loved him enough to cause a Trojan War. They say that nobody ever loved as much as she. But me, I love you
more than a hangman loves his rope.
More than a dopey loves his dope.
More than a ninja loves his scalpel.
More than a yodeler loves his up.
More than there once was a man.
Man, a woman.
She was one he
slew. He was one that
bore. They say that nobody ever loved as much as she.
Well?
Look at the reason they're talking to the pastor right now.
I'm steering clear there.
Sure thing.
I told you we wouldn't get no place.
He's a fighter, he says. What a line.
You should have heard him.
Excuse me, Mr. Pastor would like to see you again.
More soft soap!
Now make quiet, Dan.
Before you go, I just want to add one thought. That's not a journey with any hard feelings. I want to preserve that
Sleep tight, spirit.
Well, that's easy to say, Mr. Hassler, but we're not getting any place.
We're going backwards.
I didn't say no. I said not now.
Look, this thing's been dragging on for months. The help are getting very jumpy. Their patience is about wore out.
Look, I want to be fair, but...
Now, look, I'm going to tell you the plain truth. We know this company's doing one hell of a business. We ain't got no education, maybe, but we got eyes and ears.
Everybody in the industry has had a 7.5 cent raise.
As I said, I want to be fair. That's why I don't give you a yes, but I don't give you a no either. I say we have to examine it. I have to go before the board of directors. And that's how it's gonna stay.
What now, Prez?
Slow down.
Slow down? Attaboy, slow down. This is it, this is what we've been waiting for.
Yeah, you can start someplace.
This is your room, babe. Go to it. Slow down.
See the superintendent? Well, what's going on right here?
Yeah, twice. Better forget her, her with her nose in the air. She has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care. Won't you take this advice I hand you? Seeing things too clear? Are you too much in love to hear? Is it all going in one ear? And out the other?
the plane. Y'all know as good as I. And any of the members of the type I run into from time to time who say, what good is the union? Why should I pay my dues? Why, they could get a mighty good object lesson from where we'd be in this here battle for the 7.5 cent raise that they wouldn't get if it wasn't for the union. What sure as hell gonna get it? So leave us all remember that our union should be first and foremost in our minds, next only to our loved ones and the tiny tots and kitties. Now, before we get things started here, we're gonna have a little entertainment. And I hope tonight y'all are gonna show a special courtesy because some of the cutting room boys has got up an act with Miss Gladys Hotchkiss from the front office. And if these good folks is good enough to come down here and do this act for us, why, the least you can do is not to sneak out the back way, like last time. And you, get your hand off that blonde. This is a family show. And look at that t-shirt. That is so unoriginal. Now, this little number that they got worked up is something that's right on the nose, because it's about getting hot. And fellow union members, that's what we're doing, getting hot.
I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I need your love to keep away the cold. I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I can't get warm without your hand to hold. The radiator's hissing, still I need your kissing to keep me from freezing each night. I got a hot water bottle, but nothing I got'll take the place of you holding me tight. I got steam heat, I got steam heat, I got steam heat, but I need your love to keep away the cold.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now, May, start paying attention to the meeting and quit guzzling all this free beer.
I ain't guzzling. I'm just being sociable.
Well, this ain't sociable. It's an official meeting.
Well, May here's got to keep up her strength.
Now, look, we can't just sit around here and do nothing. We gotta make plans. Hassler ain't gonna give in easy.
But we got to slow down.
Yeah.
I mean other things, like, why, a suggestion from Jake Fondermeyer. He says when he was working at the Ironclad Overall Company and they was having trouble, while they spit tobacco juice in the back hip pockets of all the overalls.
I draw the line at chewing tobacco. Mm-hmm.
I wasn't suggesting that.
Well, how about if we have the package with the large-sized bottoms and the small-sized tops like that?
Sure.
Yeah.
Now, see, that's what I'm talking about. That's clear thinking. That's constructive.
Hello? Oh, sure, I recognize your voice.
But that wouldn't take effect soon enough. Well, I suppose not.
Yes, I am.
Let's be practical.
I'm gonna break down and have another beer.
No, I can't talk right now. I've been away for 3 days.
We gotta put the screws on them right now, not later.
Well, look, I have several people over here and, well, it wouldn't do any good anyhow. So goodbye. I'm sorry.
Listen, babe, some of the people been saying, well, I don't want to get Babe into trouble, but...
Well, go ahead. What trouble can you get me into? I'm fired already.
The union ought to do something about that, too.
Well, if she hadn't stood right up and said she did it, we could have. But if somebody up and admits they've been busting up the company property...
I know.
Listen, here's a confidence just inside the committee. Some of the buttons ain't been sewed on too good. When the salesman comes screaming back to Hassler.
That'd be great.
Hello!
Mr. Williams.
Baby, today, huh?
Yep.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Pop.
Well, don't let me interrupt.
Well, how was your trip?
Dirty. Got a hot box on the side for 25 minutes.
Well, that's about it, anyhow.
Sure.
Well, let's all be thinking new ways to jam things up. Mm-hmm.
Much obliged for the beer.
Well, that's all right.
What do you mean you gotta go home?
Look, mate, my wife will be raising hell.
Too bad you didn't think about that before.
Look, I'll take you home.
Don't bother.
But, mate, there's prowlers out at this hour of night.
Single ones, I hope.
Come on. Well, I stopped in at the Crawler Tavern today. Guess who I ran into?
An old man Hassler and Rita Hayworth?
Nah, Sid.
Sid? Well, what's he up to?
Well, from what I get, he's been phoning you or something of that sort.
Yeah.
What happened to you two?
Never mind, Pop.
That's what I told him. I told him just forget it. Come on.
Oh, Pop, you're too fresh.
That boy don't feel right about something.
Well, neither do I.
Come on in, Sid.
Yes, do come in.
Have you really been away?
Well, sure. I've been in Chicago visiting the Lincoln Park Zoo.
Just because we're on different sides. Is that any reason for us to get all balled up?
Looks like it, doesn't it?
Not to me, it doesn't. What kind of queen are you anyway?
Well, Sid, haven't you heard? I'm the sweetheart of Local 343, Associated Garment Workers of North America. My gosh, Sid, I warned you. I told you, you know all about how I felt. I happen to think there are certain things a person needs to stand for in this lifetime. But I guess you forgot about all of that.
I forgot about nothing. I'm paid to run that factory.
So run the factory. You stick to your side, I'll stick to mine.
Miss Williams, I love you. Corny, ain't it? Did you hear me?
Yes.
Can't you see my side of it? I can't fail at this. I was a cutting room foreman before I bluffed my way up to this job. Now I'm fighting to stay here. Now that you're in my plans, I'm fighting even
yeah,
harder.
Yeah, relax those hands, Tycoon.
Well, here we are.
What you got there, Pop? Your stamp album?
Oh, now don't get excited. Sid don't have to look at him if you don't want to.
But Pop, Sid loves stamps. He told me so. Don't you, Sid?
Yeah, we were looking at them the other night.
Sure. You're about to be in stamps. I need to be interested.
Oh, Sid's very interested, Pop. But me, I'm just plain bush, so you don't mind if I slip off to bed, do you?
Run along, honey. Good night.
Good night. Sleep well.
Thanks.
Sid. Let's say we start with the Pan-American issue first.
Seems like good as place as any to start, doesn't it?
Stars in your eyes. Love never made a fool of you. You used to be too wise. Hey there, you on that high flying cloud. Though you've been acting cold to him, you know your heart is sold to him. Head on the ball, girl. Just take it all in your stride. Don't let him make you fall apart. You've always had such pride. Won't you take this advice I hand you like a brother? Or are you not seeing things too clear? Are you too much in love to hear?
Women. That's what I do, especially on Liberty.